Okay, sweet. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today we are gonna be streaming Firewatch again for part 2. And hopefully we can finish this. Yeah, we were had to figure out a way to get in here. And weirdly enough, I could have maybe in order for it to do.
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place. I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in 2 shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Look for the controlled burn south of Ruby River. Okay, let's make sure we're going there. That looks like... That's so anyways. It sucks because I kind of forgot the controls, like, I don't remember if there was a, the controls. Looks like there is no jump button. Which is weird, because I could have swore I remembered jump. Oh, here we go. Okay, sweet. So now if we look at the map, we should be able. Wait. Right. So all we have to do is go to the south of the Ruby River, which is quite a long ways away, but luckily I know how to use the map, because I remember during the beginning of the gameplay, I didn't even know how the map worked, really. Okay, it looks like we... Oh, I wonder why it says east of the lake with the eyeball symbol.
Should we call the cops or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
Don't you think that would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
I don't know. Tell them we're being bothered or something.
Henry, I really like this job, okay? And if I give off even a hint of cuckoo to my bosses, they are never gonna let me back out here. Do you understand that?
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Sorry about that, guys. Great. Okay, hopefully it's working. That stupid battery's decided to die at the worst time ever, so I just completely missed the dialogue. So freaking annoying. I hate batteries so much. That's one reason I hate console with a passion, is because... I mean, I can't really say much about computer because I've never played. One nice thing is you don't have to worry about stupid batteries dying in the middle of your stream. Let's see here. This way.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been. Don't expect you to care as much about it. I'm probably just working myself up into a tizzy over nothing. Sorry, we just need to focus on what's happening to us.
Wait. Three blind rats instead of three blind mice. That's funny. Let's see here now. Find the firefighters and scout. Is this it?
Hey, I found a pair of old totaled snowmobiles out here. Looks like someone stripped them of a bunch of parts.
Huh.
And that's weird, right?
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
An old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah, where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
Yeah, I suppose. I see, we're close. Yep, camp is over this way somewhere. Camp. Opera. Ara. Oh. Rap.
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
Of course.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Huh. Wait, we made it.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the Weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
I'm at the camp.
Great. Have a look around. If anyone's still there, they might be able to help.
I'm gonna sound crazy.
Maybe you just ask them to help you get inside the fence. If I didn't know it was out there, they probably don't either.
This place looks dead, but I'll see what I can find. There are bear traps out here, in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up.
Yeah, this place looks like it's wrecked. I'm really curious where this is gonna go.
You ever talk to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
I mean, he wasn't a scout or a Weeblo or whatever?
I got the sense that boy could barely tie his shoes, let alone a clove hitch.
What the hell's a clove hitch?
Ah, well, it's a knot that you are probably too old and too stubborn to learn. You use it to make rafts and shelters and stuff like that.
Huh. You know how to tie one?
Heck no, I'd make a Weeblo do it.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
I'm gonna do a scan for supplies and then figure out a way to get back over that ravine and hike towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Well, I don't see any supplies, sadly. I forgot that we jumped down that thing, so stuck over here. It's so annoying because in real life I could easily cross that. Oh, there we go.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
Oh yeah, here we go. Sweet. Oh, sweet. Yeah, this makes life a little easier. Okay, now we gotta go all the way back.
I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck.
There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Oh, I guess we don't have to go all the way back then. Day 77.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The June fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
I didn't sleep a wink last night, and I've been going crazy for the past 6 hours of sunup. How are you so chipper?
Well, it's a new day. What a day, this day we've been given.
Maybe I am actually asleep right now. Maybe I didn't stay up all night knowing that someone is...
I actually slept just great.
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
She's acting pretty sus.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Let me look at it and I'll tell you.
No. You don't need to tell me, just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Which tree am I supposed to internalize again?
Top row, second from the left. Head to a place named after that tree, and you'll have a wonderful afternoon.
Cottonwood?
Oh, yeah, okay. Maybe I should go for a hike.
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya.
Radio
me the moment you get there.
Okay, let's check out our map. This way is. I got some toilet paper so I can wipe my ass. Okay. Okay. Okay, it looks like straight. Take it. I don't like them. Wrestling at them.
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
You see the cash box there?
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
It's crazy.
I got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
Yeah, now we're talking.
Whatever these people are doing is illegal, right?
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Our radios are tapped? Are you fucking serious?
Our radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know?
You know that I'm scared. None of it makes any sense.
Who is doing this?
Henry, I've been at this job off and on for 13 years. Sometimes here, sometimes over near Jackson, a couple times down in Wind River. And nothing like this has ever happened before.
Are there any other lookouts this is happening to? Someone else in on this? Anyone?
This is just happening to us. Everyone else is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved. Our fucking state coordinator asked if I was just having lady troubles. So no, this isn't happening to anyone else, and I'm done asking.
Am I just making all of this up? I mean, the eavesdropping, the spying, is this... Fuck, are you... Is any of this real?
That'd be crazy if I saw this.
Are you serious?
Maybe I'm just losing my mind.
What?
Like Julia. And maybe it's happening to me, and I'm imagining that I have a boss out here and that we're being spied on.
Henry.
Maybe there was something in the water, or our condo was underneath some power lines, and you, Delilah, you're not real.
Henry, think about her. If what happened to her were happening to you, you wouldn't even be able to realize it.
Okay.
Sweetie, I am real, and this is happening. I'm as real as the sky is blue. Take a second, and then call me back. I'm on your side. Just thought of something not great.
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls, the ones that went missing a few weeks back.
Oh, shit.
My thoughts exactly.
Our radios were tapped. And now, someone probably has a transcript of that entire conversation.
Oh, no.
And I've filed a report that's a blatant lie.
And those girls are still missing.
Yep.
Fuck, Delilah.
Fuck, indeed. We really need to get to the bottom of this.
I just wanted to make sure and double check we're supposed to. Okay, so yeah, I just have to follow this up. That with our trusty axe, we should definitely be able to.
Whoa. Ow!
Damn, can't report staying anymore.
See anybody around?
Lucky for us.
Yeah, lucky for us. There's some serious comms equipment out here, wireless stuff.
What do you mean?
I'm talking a big 20-foot tall transmission tower, and they could probably listen to whoever the hell they want. They're nestled down in this valley, which makes it impossible for you or any lookout to see them. Doing something with the soil out here too. It's all gridded off. Hey, maybe you were right about the lichens. And there's all sorts of contraptions and shit out here.
Like what?
Dishes and stuff on metal legs. There's wires all over the place. I don't know. I'm not really up on high tech.
Yeah, me either.
In their main tent.
What's it like?
It's definitely some sort of monitoring station. Okay, this thing is losing its mind, beeping like crazy.
I can hear it. What's it after?
I don't know. I'm gonna go find out. Are you shitting me?
What is it?
There's a folder of reports here.
What do they say?
They're assessments about the two of us. There's stuff in here about Julia.
Like what?
Stuff I didn't tell you. This is...
What does it say about me? You said there was one about me.
And it looks like they've been following me around. What I do when I'm out hiking? Jesus!
Henry, do you hear me?
It says that you and your boyfriend are still together.
What? We're not. They're messing with us.
Yeah. Okay.
They are. How do they even know who he is? How the hell does this... I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down.
Yeah, fuck them.
They'll dump an ocean of water on it, and these assholes will spend the rest of the summer picking up the pieces. We get to finish out our contracts. Hell, we'll even call in the fire.
Yeah, okay.
You don't sound too excited about that.
I'm not.
Look, worst case scenario...
The whole forest burns down along with whoever's in it?
Fuck. Yeah. Worst case. Well, maybe it's not the best idea.
Yeah, it's definitely not the best idea.
Oh, I'm so fucking wound up!
It's all right. I'm just gonna hike back. We have the wave receiver, and tomorrow we can figure out what to do. Okay. Shit. Got a map here that confirms they're tracking my...
I'm gonna look at this.
People's movements.
Fucking radio.
The map's got all sorts of paths and areas marked off on it. There are lines that look like some of the paths I normally take.
Are you positive it's you?
I'm not sure, but I think so.
Yeah, this is crazy. I wonder what the hell they're studying, because it says program status review, 10 weeks. Conservation, observational traits, reliable, observant, charismatic, selfish, skewed perception of persons, never married, no kids, rarely hikes or leaves immediate surroundings, multiple lovers despite long tie partner, Javier. That's so weird. Susceptibility and manipulation is 3 out of 10. Like, what is this? What the hell are they trying to study? Okay, so now we just need to go back to the lookout tower.
There's smoke coming from the site. I just climbed out of there and the bridge collapsed.
What the hell happened to you? It's definitely not the best idea.
It wasn't me.
What do we do?
We just call it in like any other fire.
And what about who started it? What about them?
The person who started it?
Yeah.
We're talking about people watching us out here who are now burning the forest and everything in it around us. I don't know what to do about that.
Except get the hell out.
Yes, get us the hell out of here.
I will.
Day 77.
This receiver picked something up. I'm just checking it out.
What? What thingy? What now?
I found a device that picks up frequencies. It's how I found the reports last night, and it's going off now.
It just picked up a frequency?
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
All right, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
Hey, Dee, I don't want to harsh your vibe, but maybe, just maybe, that's a bad idea.
Henry.
What?
You're harshing my vibe. My thinking is I could stay up all night worried I'm going to lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is I'm going to follow this wave receiver.
Ooh, I like it when you think.
Oh, what the?
I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are. Last thing I need is another big crossword breakthrough.
Oh, that's a trap.
Shit! What?
This is weird. Ah, it's a key for the cave. I figured they'd come.
I found some sort of supply bag, light camping gear, some clothes, you know, basics, but it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine, but there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout.
Oh, no.
And it's not you.
Is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going.
Okay, excellent one. This should take it. Wait. There's no jump scare way.
I don't see anyone up here.
She was just there.
Talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
Oh, no.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh, my God, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
Oh no, hopefully we don't get accused of that.
Sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
We have to stick together, okay? Keep our story straight. From the first day with those girls to the person breaking in on our conversation, everything. We gotta be honest and consistent.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
Sweet, we get to go explore that cave now.
actually make that call, right? To the other lookout. It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kinda just wish I hadn't.
Of course I didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
That's not gonna happen, though.
Thanks, Henry.
Wait. I knew the cave was gonna come into play sometime. Didn't know when.
What the hell?
It's gonna
Jesus,
be cool.
This is a big cave.
It's gonna be cool to see what the deal with this cave.
Freezing in here.
I think caves are cool, but in real life, I don't know if I'd want to actually go in one. Seen too many horror stories. Caves.
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No, there's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. Bunch of rocks stacked up, he made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was gonna get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much. Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, Sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
Yeah, but not smarter than yours truly, right?
Wait, are you seriously feeling threatened by the intelligence of a 12-year-old you've never even met?
I'm just saying, I'm pretty, with it. I'm a pretty bright bulb.
Yeah, Henry, you're a regular Rhodes Scholar.
Nice. I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler. It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and... I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied. And just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and... I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left.
Says it somewhere over. Yeah, this is it.
He'd hide out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow. Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband which gives him superpowers.
Well, that's fucking dark.
I apologize that it takes a long time to figure this stuff out. It's my first time playing. I looked at the map and it said it's not letting me climb rocks or anything. Don't understand. And I'm pretty sure I examined everything at that kid's camp, so I don't really know why I can't. I tried, there's like a little, there's a steep slope, but there's no way to like attach a line or anything. Not that I see it. Might temporarily stop screen recording. Get up quick. Okay, so it's telling me I have to grab a jacket. Down here.
Huh. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
Hi, my name is Brian Goodwin. If you found this note, it should be with a bunch of climbing. I hope. Could you? They are my...
There's a busted old toy out here, some sort of electronic game.
Yeah? I like Pong.
Everybody likes Pong.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
Oh, that's cool. It's like an old Game Boy.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half-elf, armor 7.
Classic wizards and wyverns.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him, you know, tinkering on stuff like that.
He made the place pretty comfy, too.
That's an achievement.
Yeah, at the expense of what are probably stolen pillows.
That little shit!
Wait, now we can finally get down here. I thought this would probably be the way, but I guess we had to collect stuff.
What do you think is in there?
Hmm. I'm probably going to get killed.
Something that will kill me. So, you know, just sort of getting myself right with God or whatever there is.
Henry.
They closed the door when they could have just...
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
No, I think I'm probably good. Bring on jail.
You'd probably just get probation. I'd be the one stuffed away in the Lusk women's prison for the next 10 years. Oh, also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
Oh, no.
I wonder if they know anything. If there's some way to ask them about whatever happened at their camp.
I think we'd be smart to let sleeping dogs lie.
You're probably right.
Oh, okay. I hope I see it. Deeper into the... has to be a Oh, there we go. What's that? Oh no.
You're Brian Goodwin.
No way. Aw. That's insane. Poor kid. I definitely was not expecting that. That's pretty crazy.
Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worried my ass off.
Oh no, she's gonna be so sad.
Hey, you, might wanna take a seat.
I've been sitting this entire time. I'm almost always sitting. What's wrong?
The only thing in the cave was a body.
A body? God, what a mess.
Delilah. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. Whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
Oh, damn, it's your last day. Sweet, hopefully we'll finally get to figure out what the hell's going on. Back up a lot.
see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Well, is this the June fire, or the site fire, or...
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Does there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us. Whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I was hoping you'd have a backup.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah.
I'll remember you. That's how she said.
Ontario, maybe.
No, I meant if something happens to me.
Right. If you don't find out who made the tape and I have to hit the road.
Forget it.
Be safe, Henry.
If I don't make it, I'll remember you.
What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
Alright, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Huh. Oh, sweet.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for fuck's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
Found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. He's deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
He's got a survival bunker with radios and everything. He made it all up.
You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay.
Okay, we need to go to third. Sick. feel like that once we get to the evacuation point, something's gonna happen. Because we haven't gotten very many answers on what the whole plan is. The only thing I know so far is that the dude's son died in an accident. Going up. Okay, so I think those green arrows on the map are the climb. I was trying to figure out what the hell on the map represented the climbing areas. But let's check the map. Yep, that's right. I don't know if we want to go out. I think we have to, though. Oh, sweet, okay, we're on.
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. It was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
was an accident. And I don't think Ned meant to kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
Yeah, that's true, we don't.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry? Sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there, so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Dee, what if they don't come back for me?
They'll come back. That's their job.
Just what if we missed something about, something, I don't know.
Henry, you're tired. There's nothing big going on. They'll come back for you.
Just wait.
I'm gonna go.
Oh no.
If you have to.
I have to. Hike safe.
I have a feeling some. Well, anticipation is killing me. I'm so curious what's gonna happen. I just have this feeling that whatever happens is not. Oh, the music. And help, but the trails in this game are marked. Doesn't there supposed to be a trail like right here? It'd also help if there wasn't so freaking dusty. It looks like we're in the middle of a dust bowl. Thank you. I think I found. I was so worried I was gonna get lost again. But it looks like we... But it looks like we wanna... Okay, yep, this is the right... It is this place. I thought it was going to lead to this. Oh, I see, there's a... Is this the girls? Oh, pork pond sign. So she's the one that stole it. I remember earlier she was saying someone stole the pork pond sign. It was her. Thank you.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Huh.
Well, yeah.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Probably the one who attacked my face.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe... Maybe you could come back to Boulder with me and figure it out down there. Just a thought.
You don't want me down there.
Well, I just asked you.
Look, I've got some things to do in Casper, and maybe I'll head south sometime after that. I could come by, sure.
Okay. So, what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I am. Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
She won't even recognize me, Delilah.
You're not just going for her.
You don't know what it's like.
Bad things happen, okay? And you have to find a way to contain the damage. A good way.
Well, hopefully I can figure out a way to do that.
Yeah, I hope so.
God, this got dark.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
There's the helicopter.
Good. They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
You too. Good luck.
You keep it for yourself. Bye, Hank.
That's it. I honestly,
something.
skip the credits because I'm gonna put this on YouTube. So I don't want to get cut. But yeah. Honestly, I have no idea what happened. So we were inside the girls' lookout tower, and there was a drawing of me, like she was studying me and part of the group that was spying on us. So, but then they kind of made it seem like the dude that, the person that was spying on us was the dad of that one kid. And he ended up dying, and the dad tried to cover it. I don't want to say, I guess he kind of did try to, like, cover it up. He didn't report his son dying. I don't know. This story was kind of a mind fuck. But it was kind of interesting. I'll have to, maybe what I'll do is I'll look up a video explaining the backstory of it. Explain better, and then maybe I'll make a video my reactions then, because I for some reason just could not put the pieces together in this story. It happens sometimes, but I think it was a pretty good game though for the most part. It wasn't the worst game I ever played in my life, but there was another. Oh yeah, that's right. It reminds me kind of The Evil Within. That was one of my favorite games, like, story-wise, but I completely did not understand the story of that game until I watched a YouTube video that put the pieces together for me and showed everything. I was like, holy crap, this game is really deep. And I was like, oh my god, the story is really good, but they didn't do the best job, like, at putting the pieces together so you can figure it out. But yeah, only thing I really know about this story was that he had a wife that got dementia or something. She went to Australia with her mom and dad and went to this job to try to get his mind off that lady that he worked with, that was like low-key flirting with him at some points, it seemed like. And then there was the girls that disappeared. This game was kind of trippy because it like acted like things were gonna be bad. Like, there was those girls at the lake and they were like swimming, and we found their campsite and it looked like someone just like pretty much kidnapped them. And then we found out later, oh no, they're fine. They just took a farmer's tractor and went for a joyride and got rested. And there's just multiple points in the game, like a couple different points where they made you think, like, get really bad, and then it turned out normal. So it just kind of was like a, I guess you could say at some points of the game it's kind of like a psychological thriller, because, like, it made you, like, oh my god, and then I was like, oh. And then there was that whole thing with the boy and his dad, and that was crazy, because we literally were, like, just at his fort thing there, and he was like, oh, here's the climbing equipment, I want you to send it back to my dad. I was gonna read the whole letter, but somebody rudely told me to move on. Cause drama. Stop reading it, but I know that he was talking about something about the climbing gear he borrowed from his dad, and he wanted to send it back to the person who read the letter, to send it back to his dad in Nebraska, so. And then, not too long after, we found his body, so. And then found out that the dad, for some reason, was spying on us. I really don't know why. I just remember him saying that his son died in an accident, and he it wasn't his fault, and that's about all I know of the story. So, I want to thank you guys, though, for joining me on this journey. Interesting. And sorry if there were some points where I was kind of quiet. I was getting kind of frustrated with the map because I got lost a lot, and I was trying to focus really hard on trying to figure stuff out. So, whenever I'm really deep into Thon trying to figure stuff out, I get really... It sucks because I have my TV that I gotta look at, and then I have my phone down here I gotta look at while I'm streaming. I have to check and see if there's any people messaging in the chat sometimes. And that doing all this stuff can really make me focused really hard and make it sometimes hard for me to talk. I think it also depends on the game too. Like, if I was playing something different where it's... This was a very story-based game, so it required a lot of listening too, so that's probably another reason talkative. And sometimes it helps too if I get more of a chat, like in my last stream, my buddy and his sister joined my stream and we were chatting pretty much a majority of the stream, so it was a little more chatty on that one. We finished it though. We got her done. I'm excited because now I can actually watch YouTube videos of this without being spoiled because I played the game. So I can actually go look up a video and see what this whole game was about. But yeah, I've been rambling on for a while. But I just really appreciate anyone who watched this on the stream. And I'm going to post it on YouTube. Anyone who sees it on YouTube, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. I really hope you enjoy it, even though I don't talk as much. But yeah, it means a lot. Thank you, guys. This journey has been interesting. I'm thinking of doing this game called The Great Outdoors next. It's said to be like a really bad game, and I'm curious why it has so much hate, so I kind of want to play it to see what it's like. Maybe I could do that for a series on my YouTube channel. I can do like really bad games and see like what makes them so bad. Maybe that'd be like an interesting set, like an interesting type of content I could make for the channel. But thank you guys. I hope you have a great day or night, and I just really appreciate you for checking me out and channel, like joining me on this journey, this crazy journey that we went on together. And I hope to see you guys in the next video and the next live stream. Just, yeah, thank you. Stop live stream.